You have to remember to enjoy it, you know. It don't come around again. Personally, like, was like, shit, this is it. This is, I'm sort of living what I've always wanted to do. You know, especially on this tour, was like, ah, it's like the debut album again. It's like, come on, this is it. Velociraptor was the sound of futuristic rock band. So visually, we wanted to represent that, and that's where we started. From first seeing the stage, it was magnificent, sort of. It's always a nice feeling.
Wow.
Great, innit?
It's kind of like ice hockey. They're all like, you know, ice hockey arenas, ain't they?
Hi, Dave.
How are you doing?
Are you excited?
Yeah.
How are you?
And what was so Europe? This wasn't happening in Europe.
A bit.
What were you having
it in Europe? Yeah, good times actually.
Yeah?
Really good times.
I just got on it.
Yeah.
Nice hair.
Thanks, man. But
I know what. I think we really, really got it right, combining, you know, what we'd seen at dance festivals and what we'd seen great rock bands do. Sort of really got it right in combination of the two. And then when we saw that stage, this huge sigh of relief. And also, this is gonna be something no one's seen before, which is a great feeling.
And then, I don't even know the order, then we go on, then he comes out.
No, we're on, we're playing. He's singing the first half of the verse in behind the thing.
He's not.
And there'll be someone singing, but they won't know where it's coming from. Where the fuck is it? And I see on the screen, it's fucking digitalized Tom.
No.
He comes in on,
because I'm
having a bit.
Right, you ready? I'm buzzing now, you know what I mean? Oh, yeah, that honey's great. It's just my mind, isn't it? Stop it, say it. Slap.
It's the intensity grows every time.
Well, originally, we were trying to create sort of neon church was the sort of initial feeling, you know, like, you know, ancient times, you know, when you go and see the shaman or, you know, preacher or whoever, and they sort of stand in front of these huge. So we wanted a structure that was like that, and it was really difficult to do. So then it was kind of this sort of half eye kind of vibe. And we looked at the Hollywood Bowl as well, because that's got the same sort of thing. But then we wanted to have it at an angle as well. So it felt imposing, like it was sort of coming out at you.
50% of me is overwhelmed and like, I can't believe it all coming together, finally, you know. And the other 50% of me is like going sick over the details, you know what I mean? And I'm like, there's that many details to sort out. And I know that once they get sorted out tomorrow, that's when it will become a fucking life changer.
You know what, that was all right, you know? For like a dress rehearsal, it was all right. Interesting, good space to play in. We're given this chance to be in a rock and roll band, so we may as well take it and try and blow people's minds, you know? Give them a show where they go, what the fuck just happened to me, you know what I mean? Rather than playing it safe and playing it easy, that ain't really us. You know, it's pretty invincible at the moment, so bring on the shows, you know?
Oh.
not bad.
Not bad? It's not bad for a little band from Leicester.
Yeah, it's not bad.
Oh, let's get out of here.
The fuck out of here.
Do you think fire, it didn't feel...
visually?
Booming.
Oh, yeah, yeah, no.
Basically, what, you know, part of that is because where we were at before, a lot of, you know, there's a few tracks where we had to pull back lights. It's a bit too dark again, but I can make, we're going to go lighter lavenders and stuff like that. We wanted to change it from reds and stuff for obvious reasons, you know what I mean? Like,
no, of course. Definitely.
That's one of our notes for tonight to sort.
In my opinion, mate, that is we're closer together on stage than we ever have been, which is better. And we're more, I don't know, what if a silly thing to say, more of a rock show? That's a crazy thing to say, but, you know, we're closer together, you know, which feels good.
I think it's the most relaxed.
Yeah, exactly, we've ever been, so.
It's the biggest it's ever been, it's the most relaxed we've ever been.
We've never been this sexual ever, have we, Jay?
No, I've never been rubbed like this.
I've never been rubbed like this. Never been rubbed like this.
Rubber's never been rubbed like this. Yeah.
Fucking hell, it's flat as fuck. It's like Elvis. Oh, fucking hell. I put my whole body in that. It's big. Let's see
how they feel. Have to warm up, I think, innit?
Now. It's like when you get to the top of the Nemesis and you shit it.
Right, I'm up, brothers. Let's have this fun. We're gonna light him up.
First show in Belfast, you know, you never know until you hit the first note. The roar, when you get that back, you put out maximum and you get maximum level back. It gives you such a buzz, makes for an incredible night.
It's real, it's not pure, is it?
Fuck,
because I am ticking backwards.
It's massive, mate.
Young crowd went into it. It's a good first day back.
You know, it shows that we're going in the right direction. You know, we're getting new fans. And West Rider and this album, it shows that people are actually getting into it.
Tomorrow we go to Motherland, where my ancestors come from, my grandma and granddad and my father. Dublin. You'll find out. Now my friends are sharp as razors. Cut you down if you touch the fader. Listen up, you masquerader. We have got the floor.
It's saw like a new generation, and I felt like there's a lot more sort of circles of death, the correct name for them, where they sort of get people spreading out and making huge circles, and then on the drops, everyone just going crazy.
Like when the shit kicks back in, no one fucking stands still. Nobody stands still. Get loose, including you fuckers there. Get loose, get loose. 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 Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, 4.
When we first played tunes like Switchblade and Vlad, it confused people because of its nature, it's out there. Now people have understood it. And playing that was as big as fire. We're getting into sort of more dance heads as well. There's that going down as well, which is really special.
One of the best things I've ever seen. You know, the circle. There are people in the crowd, you know, the fluorescent shirts. Right, so every time a circle, you know, the death circle, they were in the middle, fucking stopping it.
Really?
Right?
Wow.
And I've seen one geezer on LSF, full fucking like fluorescent. He's obviously in the crowd stopping, he's like going, ah! Having it to voice, he's going, Carlos, are you working, you cunt?
Yeah, well, we've got Jay, who's been with us now for a long while, he's the real deal, you know, like, he can play slide guitar, he used to be a preacher, he used to be a grave digger, looks like one of the Velvet Underground. I mean, you know, they don't come around those people anymore. From Philadelphia, we'd wear the cheeses for.
You know, my dad dug ditches for a living. Look at me, I got hair and makeup. It's ridiculous. You know, the best rock and rollers look like ugly women, not like good-looking men. Think of any of them, you know what I mean? Ron Wood, Rod Stewart. They look like really ugly chicks. They look like good-looking dudes. That's a fact.
It's the dark side of Leicestershire.
Get in there.
That's pretty epic. I didn't realise it was a concave stage. You come in, because when you look at it,
it
just looks like a semicircle,
yeah.
And then you see it from the side. Fucking hell. So that in the O2 is going to be epic.
I mean, that's kind of where
absolutely
that's what it's built for.
Epic, yeah. Oh, mate.
That's the thing about touring, it's really difficult to keep it all together because you're drinking and you stay up late and you're playing shows and there's this and that, and you know, it gets on top. You kind of go, well, you know, we'll take it easy because this is going down tomorrow. There was a lot of planning on that sense, and all that went out the window because you come off stage and go, what the fuck am I going to do now? That was so incredible. Get the speakers on, get the ice out, you know. And let's sort of go fucking crazy. Ben Keeley, I've known him since like 12 or something. He was originally in the band. He was young. He was a drummer, but we always stayed really close friends. Then it was like, well, we need a keyboard player. And then when he came back into the band, you know, it was like he's a different person, you know, he wasn't like 16, you know, he was a man with a family. And again, you know, as a player, he's, there's no one better out there as a player. He's incredible, you know, one of my bestest friends in the world.
There we were, feet can't speak. I'm frightened by shadows in the autumn leaves. We want stolen hearts, vintage souls. Ain't in my eyes, I'm out of meeting in fools. Yeah, hey ho, where did it go? When do we lose our sight? 'Cause it's a night show, once we perform.
Done Cardiff, Brighton, two Nottinghams, and obviously Belfast and Dublin in there, but all been incredible. It's got to the top on about the second show, Dublin, but it's, you know, it's that, it's 100% every night. It's ridiculous.
Bradley came in first, the thing came in, and the lights, and then the spot on you after the end and stuff, and it's quite good because you were going, it's just like space time, mate. I'll just have to say it before the song, so get your phones out and our beds, kink champagne
don't
And tonight, pleasure to be joined by Tom and Serge from Kasabian. Hello, gents.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Thanks very much for coming to see us.
No problem.
Where to start? So you're currently on the road.
Yes.
How's it all going so far?
It's been great. It's been a whirlwind experience for us. Started in Belfast and we've been everywhere. You know, it's just nice to be playing. Us as a band to be on tour again is great. Properly on tour as well. I mean, like hitting a gig every night nearly, it's good, yeah.
And the crowds, like we said, we're just chatting before we started, sold out pretty
nothing,
much.
Nothing like it on earth, mate. The crowds are amazing. Yeah, most of them are sold out, and so we've done really, you know, in this day and age to do that is amazing, you know, so.
What's the encore at the moment?
It's the biggest. It's like, you know, have you ever played Street Fighter?
Yeah.
You know, like a finishing move, like the ultimate finishing move. Like, you'd have to invent new buttons.
I don't think any band could fucking fuck with the last three songs.
Seriously,
I mean it, seriously.
What is it?
It's Switchblade Smiles, Vlad Impaler and Fire. And the whole place goes to pot. Then
it's just done. You're done. You don't need to go and see anything else ever.
It's done.
Okay. Don't bother. Forget the rest of them. They're all rubbish.
Listen, I'm only saying. I'm only telling you the truth.
This is it. America, stand by. This is what's about to arrive on your shores. Amazing.
To create with the music live, the huge drops we've always had, very rarely get that in a rock show. So when we do go down low, we drop and it kicks back in. It should all hit you at the same time. Simultaneous spinning bird kicks will like hit that home like a sledgehammer.
Complete euphoria, you know, it's like a rock and roll rave. It's kind of futuristic rock and roll, which is represents what the band are as well. We're just doing our thing, you know, and we're certainly not trying to, you know, do anything other than our own path. And our paths, you know, we're very happy with where we are.
The loudest crowd I've had on tour is fucking slow to get going, but they fucking had it. For Monday night, they've just supposed to come home from work, cracked open the fucking Tennent Super Brew or whatever they drink, and just cracked on, and just they were amazing tonight. We've got a day off tomorrow, and then we've got two London O2s, Millennium Dome. Yeah, it's going to be monstrous. I'm going to film it for the DVD, be out, whenever. It's going to be fucking massive.
This is the last day, you know. Simply just disappeared. That says a lot. I mean, I think it says how good it's been. I think you don't realise. So I just had a little look at how many dead gigs we've done, and I can't. It's just gone so fast, you know, mental.
I'm not really into the future now, I'm really the past. I'm really sort of where I am right now is all I can do, because I think if I was like that, I'd be in a home. The exciting thing is where we've taken this, and we've got it there. I can't wait to see what we do next, because I don't even know that yet.